Hi, I'm Brad Capel, Mr. Waterfront Team Buyer Agent. I just sold this home and the buyers recently completed the home inspection. I'm going to show you a few of the items that they found that are common and that you may face when you purchase your waterfront home.
We started off today with a pest inspection, and we found out in the detached shed that there are some tunnels from termites, as you can see here. And the homeowner is going to have to get those addressed as soon as possible. It doesn't look like the termites are active, but there is signs that at some point in time they were present in the shed. Another issue the pest inspector found was this hole through the masonry block on the garage, which he said is a big issue because small pests and rodents can get inside and make nests.
The final issue that the pest inspector found is this carpenter bee hole that you can see here. These holes are about the size of your pinky, and you just want to get them filled and treated so that the carpenter bees don't cause any structural damage. The first thing the home inspector found was, you can see here, the exterior lighting is all broken, fallen on the ground. Most of the lights around the house are broken, so they're going to need to have that addressed as soon as possible.
Okay, here's a little 30-gallon water heater out in the detached garage, and you'll see here the inspector just pointed out that the main valve, supply valve, that's coming in has a leak, and you can see where they're starting to rust and corrode.
The home inspector found this electrical box here is not attached to the wall properly, which is a safety hazard, so they're going to need to properly attach that.
Here's another issue we found. This large crack here is the main board that's attaching the pickets to the floor is separated and pulled away.
Here's a really common problem that I seem to be running into with a lot of homes. The joists here do not have joist hangers. They're actually, if you can see here, just resting on these little 1x1 boards that are nailed in. So you have the entire deck being supported by a 1-inch board. Now they are, as you can see, they're toe-nailed in from the side, but that's a big problem. It really needs to have a joist hanger that wraps down and around. So they're going to have that addressed. And then also, another really common thing that we're finding is there's no hurricane straps. The straps would go up and attach like this on the side of the joist, which would keep it. If you got a big wind that came in under the deck and lifted the deck up in a hurricane, the deck would fly away. There's nothing keeping it from going up. So that attaches. And then also there should be brackets to attach the beam to the bottom of the joist. So three big things on this deck that need to be addressed.
I recommend every buyer get a home inspection. And these are some of the issues we found today with this property. I was able to negotiate with the seller's agent, and the seller agreed to repair all the issues. I hope you enjoyed this video and you found it informative. See you at the next Buyer Minute.